So last Monday, I went for a mountain bike ride with a buddy of mine, and it was a humbling experience, but that experience was really helpful, really powerful for me. Hi there, I'm Kyle Gillette, owner of Gillette Solutions, and today I want to talk to you about the power of pushing, the power of being pushed and getting outside of your comfort zone. And we all know this, we've all heard this before, but this was a very eye-opening experience for me. So last summer, I rode mountain bikes a lot. I'd go to this mountain called Galbraith, which is close to my house, and I'd ride probably twice a week and was really active, got into great shape with it, and was able to do a lot of the trails on the mountain. I felt pretty confident. Even though I have an older bike, I felt very confident, or pretty confident, while I did it. Well, I thought, well, hey, I can go with this guy. He knows what he's doing. I'm fairly confident with what I'm doing, but I knew he had a higher skill level, so it was going to be a push for me regardless of what happened that day. Well, what happened was not what I expected. And we got there, climbed up the road to get to the trail, got to the trail, climbed up the trail, and before I even got to like the third turn in the dang trail to get you up to the start of getting up to the rest of the trails, I had to stop. I had to stop because I was so tired. Any route, any curve, any turn that I was climbing up, I needed to stop, and it was embarrassing, it was exhausting. So we climbed for about an hour, and I had to rest in between kind of the steeper climbs and kind of the let's call them the blitzes as we went up. It was super exhausting and frustrating because I'm sitting there panting and huffing and puffing and I was actually getting dizzy because I was working so hard. Meanwhile, my friend, he literally never breathed hard the whole hour and 15 minutes we were out on the mountain. It was really incredible. And so afterwards, I was making fun of myself, and we were chatting about a bunch of different things. And then we decided that we're going to find another time to ride. And I promised myself that I was going to be in better shape the next time that we went, which might be this week, it could be the next week, but I needed to get on it. And I tell you this story because if you've ever huffed and puffed through a situation where you just feel out of place or, quote, out of shape for it, unprepared, in other words, you need those situations. I needed that because it pushed me. Since then, I've ridden my bike for well over an hour at crazy paces and pushed myself very, very hard. Now, I've ridden my bike longer than that, but in those, actually, it's more like an hour and 30 minutes that I've really blitzed and pushed myself very hard to get in a better shape. And if I hadn't had that experience with my friend Taylor, there's no way I would have been pushing myself this last week. And there's no way I would be pushing myself today to get in a better shape. And the same thing is 100% true with the people that you interact with. It's called the Pygmalion effect. It's the idea that you have this ideal in mind, this beauty in mind, this ideal of what you want to achieve, and you begin to actually create it. And when you speak it, you kind of speak it into existence. You speak this new idea into existence, and it becomes a reality for you. And sometimes we need someone to push us. Sometimes we need somebody like a Taylor in our lives that gets us to that next level. It could be in the sport, it could be in the business. It doesn't matter what arena of life. It's really important to find people that are at another level, not a level that you can kind of reach up to in the moment, but a level that you can't even reach in the moment so that you see how far you have to go. And it's not to beat you up, it's not to make you feel bad, because ultimately it didn't beat me up. It didn't make me feel bad. I felt bad in the sense that I didn't feel very good from all the work. But it felt great to know that, you know what, I can get there. I can shift to that next level. So today I want to challenge you to think in those terms. Think, how can you challenge yourself to get to that next level so that you can achieve at a new level, so you can achieve in places you've never thought you could. So if you'd like to learn more about what I do and how I help clients to achieve their goals through powerful accountability through the SAGE framework, please reach out to me at gillettesolutions.com, schedule a discover call, and we can talk about what next level things that you can achieve and how I can help push you to get you there and help you build the structure you need to get you there and define exactly where you want to go so that you can actually get there. Again, I'm Kyle Gillette, owner of Gillette Solutions. Find me at gillettesolutions.com. Thanks for watching.